Thanks for reminding me. Please, Nagendra, please give me 2 minutes. Tell me, Manish, anything urgent? Hello? Hello? Okay, I think button was pressed, it seems, from his end. Okay, so what is RPA? Robotic Process Automation. Okay. What is robotic process automation? Here you can see this is the robotic process automation definition. So it simply mimics a human behavior to execute a sequence of steps, okay, which leads to a meaningful activity without a human intervention. That means RPA is basically for a mimicking or imitating the human behavior. Okay, what is a human behavior? Clicking or opening an Excel application. Copying the data. See, I will show you one simple process. Okay. Excel application we have. Okay. So what is the current step at which I have performed? Opening Excel is a one action. Okay. So by using RPA tools, what we can do, we can open Excel application. That is nothing but a mimicking a human behavior. Okay. Mimicking a human behavior to execute a sequence of steps, which leads to a meaningful activity without a human intervention. See, in RPA, there are three words: robotic, process, automation. Robotic means without a human intervention, we can basically mimic our human behavior. Process means the activity. Process means we can say a set of activities is called as a process. That means opening an Excel application, opening an email, okay, and entering some details into the form. Okay, closing the application. These are actually activities, and the process is nothing but a set of activities. And then finally, automation means what actually? We are automating. That means we are mimicking the processes performed by the human. That is nothing but automation, robotic process automation. Okay, so what is the advantage with this? What are the advantages with the robotic process automation? We can reduce a full-time employment. We can reduce infrastructure. We can also reduce cost. And RPA tools are more accurate than human beings. And RPA tools are much faster than human beings. That is the reason most of the companies are start implementing the robotic process automation tools. Okay. You can ask this question, how RPA tools reduce full-time employment? As discussed, okay. So there is a accounting firm. In accounting firm, on an average, there are three shifts people are working. Okay, the first shift starts from morning 7 to evening, I think 5, and 5 to somewhere around 11, another shift. And I mean night 11 p.m. And from 11 p.m. to morning 5 p.m., morning 5 a.m., there is another shift. That means there are three shifts running. Okay. But if you use RPA tool, we can automate and execute these processes or work by the robots. Hence, we can reduce the full-time employment. Okay. Full-time employment can be reduced. What about infrastructure? See, if the person visits office and he sits over there, and so he always uses the infrastructure. A lot of infrastructure is required. But if you are running the processes through robots, I will explain how to create robots and all in RPA tools later. We can reduce infrastructure. Okay, the last one is performance. See, RPA tools basically perform very well and faster than human beings because those are actually programmed robots. Then accuracy, these robots are more accuracy more okay, they are more accurate than human beings. Then reduce cost automatically. Most of the RPA tools are much cheaper than the billing rates which we actually give to the human beings. That means if the person is working every month, at least you have to give 22 to 25,000 rupees, right? But when compared to RPA tools, that cost is very, very high. Hence, we can reduce a lot of cost if we implement the RPA tools. Okay, by 2025, as per Gartner report, many of the BPO, business process work can be removed by the robotic process automation tools. Even testing also. Okay, testing the application also can be replaced with the robotic process automation tools. What are the tools we have? Under robotic process automation tools, we have Automation Anywhere, we have Blue Prism, we have UiPath, NICE, and WorkFusion. Among these, actually, as I said, Blue Prism, it is a bit costly when we compare it with other tools. Okay. But it provides a lot of security features. That is the reason most of the banking applications and financial institutions prefer to use a Blue Prism. Okay. And coming to Automation Anywhere is almost as capable as UiPath, but it is very costly. Hence, among all five other tools, UiPath has a major market share. Major market share in RPA, robotic process automation tools. Okay. NICE and WorkFusion are actually vendor specific, means WorkFusion can only be used for Pega systems. Okay. NICE also very specific to web applications. Okay. So UiPath is one of the best tool to do robotic process automation. Okay. Then coming to UiPath, how many license are a different type of tools under UiPath? As we discussed, UiPath has two versions. One is UiPath Community and the one is UiPath Enterprise. Okay. The name itself is telling. UiPath Community. UiPath Community means, what is this UiPath Community? UiPath Community is free and unlimited access to the UiPath. That means you no need to procure any kind of licenses for UiPath Community. Is it clear? May I know who has joined? Is it Anil? Can you unmute yourself and convey? Is it Anil?
Yes, sir.
Okay, Anil. Yeah, we just started, Anil. Okay, no problem. We just continue. We are just discussing about introduction to UiPath. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. See, UiPath has two versions. One is UiPath Community, another one is UiPath Enterprise. Okay. UiPath Community is a free and open source tool. And UiPath Enterprise is actually a licensed one. When we compare to UiPath Community, UiPath Enterprise has more features. But when you are going for interviews, okay, they won't ask the features provided by the UiPath Enterprise. Okay, definitely they won't ask. Why? Why? See, most of the students or most of the people, they apply for a UiPath developer jobs. There are different type of roles in UiPath. Okay, one is a developer role. Developer role to develop the process, UiPath Community Edition is sufficient. Okay, then what about enterprise? What are the features we have? Enterprise has a architect level functionalities. That means capturing the activities and capturing the processes, streamlining the process can be done using the UiPath Enterprise. So in our training, we are just limiting to the UiPath Community where we are going to develop the process. Okay. Then coming to what are the components we have in UiPath. Okay. But one more thing, as we discussed, we have so many RPA tools, Automation Anywhere, Blue Prism, UiPath, NICE, and WorkFusion. WorkFusion, they don't have any trial version also. WorkFusion is a Pega tool provided by the Pega systems. you have to procure the entire Pega suite, then only you will get a workforce fusion. Otherwise, you don't get. That means we can't use a workforce UA fusion, sorry, workforce RPA tool without procuring a Pega systems licenses. NICE also same. And coming to Blue Prism, as I told you, it is a highly secured, but very costly. And there is no trial version also for Blue Prism. Sorry, community edition for a Blue Prism. Automation, even though they are providing a community edition, okay, this is actually a limited feature, not like UiPath. UiPath has provided the entire functionality of UiPath Enterprise. But automation anyway, they have provided very, very basic functionalities of the RPA tool. That is the reason many students are learning Blue Prism. Blue Prism is the number one tool in a RPA market where it can be used to automate a robotic process automation. Okay. And coming to UiPath components, what are the components we have in UiPath? Okay. Very simple. Any tool, if you take, there are multiple components because one tool cannot fulfill the requirements of robotic process automation. Okay. In UiPath, there are four components. Actually, total five components. I will explain one by one. First one is UiPath Studio. Okay, you know Visual Studio, right? All right. Visual Studio. So what it does actually, Visual Studio? Basically, we create a sample program. Okay. So this is a Visual Studio. And then if you want to create a project, what ideally we do, we simply create a new project. Okay. In this new project, we simply create a Hello World application. This is a console application. You just select in the console application, click next. Okay. So console application name, I'm just giving a Hello World. Okay. Hello World. Hello World. Just click create. Okay. So still taking time. See why I have taken Visual Studio. There is a reason. I will explain later. Okay. Yeah. Okay. So this is a sample class. Here you can see console.writeline of Hello World. Okay. If you just right click, okay, run this program. Here you can see the run button. First, you have to build the project, build solution, and then click run button. Okay, build started. And here you can see build succeed. Okay. Just go to run button, run, and then go and check the output. Here you can see the output. Okay, here you can see the output. See, Hello World. Okay, see what it is doing basically to create a test script or to create a program, we need a studio. Similarly, for to create a process and develop the process, add the activity, we need a studio. That's the reason we have a UiPath Studio. Okay, you can ask this question, why you have taken example of Visual Studio? Because UiPath also uses the Microsoft Visual Studio platform only, almost same. Okay, why? I will tell you one more example. Visual UiPath basically uses a VB language, VB.NET. Okay. We use VB.NET in UiPath. That is the reason actually it uses the .NET framework. .NET framework. Okay. Hence, UiPath Studio is useful to develop. Okay. To develop a code. I will explain what is code and all. So basically, how many components are there? Visual UiPath Studio, UiPath Robot, UiPath Orchestrator, UiPath Explorer, and the last one is UiPath Assistant. Okay, we have another thing called UiPath Assistant. Okay, so let's see now, UiPath Studio is over, where we develop robotic process automation code. Okay, second one is UiPath Robot. What is UiPath Robot? I told you already, robotic process automation basically create robots. These robots will execute the same task repeatedly without human intervention. Okay, so there is no human being can sit and do the execution. UiPath basically execute the process repeatedly through robots. That is the reason we have a robot functionality. So it is used to execute the process in the studio. Okay, so Nagendra, you can stop video basically. Yeah, robotic process used to execute process in the studio repeatedly by using robots. Okay, the third component is orchestrator. Okay, nothing actually, don't get confused with orchestrator. Orchestrator is basically a central repository. Okay, see, you don't create one or two robots, right? We'll create n number of robots. Ideally, we can create 3 to 4 robots. Okay. How these robots will be managed actually? Okay, we can manage these robots by using a central repository of UiPath. That is all about UiPath Orchestrator. Okay, UiPath Orchestrator. Okay, so this is a central repository of a BOAT. BOAT is nothing but, don't confuse, BOAT is nothing but a process only. Okay, process. Okay, I will explain what is process later. See, here very frequently we use two words. One is process. Okay, second one is sequence. And third one is actually activity. Okay, very frequently we use three words: process, sequence, and activity. Don't get confused. Process is nothing but a set of sequences. And sequences is nothing but a activity. That means process is nothing but a multiple sequences. Okay, sequence is nothing but a multiple activities. So what is activity? Activity is nothing but a single action performed by the human. Can you tell me a few examples for activity? Can tell me a few examples for activity? Anybody? Open Excel application. Okay. Close Notepad. Enter data into Notepad. These are actually activities. Okay. Open Excel, close Notepad, enter data into Notepad. These are activities. Okay. So process, sequence, activity. Please remember these words very, very carefully, because we very frequently use these keywords. Use these words. Process is nothing but a multiple sequences. Sequence is nothing but a set of activities. Set of are multiple activities. Activity is nothing but a single action on the application performed by the human, performed by the end user. Human or end user, one other same. Okay, end user. Example, open Excel, close Notepad, enter data into Notepad, and so on. Okay. So then what about UI Explorer? We are discussing about our fourth component, right? UI Explorer. What is this UI Explorer? UI Explorer is basically used to, okay, see, there is a close Notepad action. Close a Notepad. How to close a Notepad? Okay, so this is a Notepad. Current one is a Notepad. So there are, suppose there are 2-3 Notepads are there. Okay, at a time there are 2-3 Notepads open. Okay, 2 or 3 Notepads open. Okay, so the first Notepad is a login Notepad. There is a Notepad name called login. and second notepad name called logout, and third notepad called fund transfer. Okay, then how to distinguish it? How to identify which notepad needs to be closed? I want to close fund transfer notepad. How your UiPath recognize fund transfer notepad? Correct. See the notepad. This is another notepad. Okay, some login, you can simply say login. Okay, save this file as a login. Save as. Okay, login. Okay, so this is a login. There is another notepad, logout. Okay, open, save as, logout. Okay, see now how many notepads are there here? See, logout, untitled, and so on. But suppose I want to close untitled instead of logout. I just want to close the untitled. But suppose login, right? Where is login? Open login. Okay, login. Okay, so control F, open logout. Okay, just right click. Okay, open with notepad. Okay, logout. Okay, logout and then untitled. So login, logout, untitled, three notepads are there. I want to close untitled. Okay, but even though there are three notepads, how your UiPath tool recognize your correct. Excellent. Very good. Okay, your UiPath recognized based on the title. Here, this one. Logout is the right. By using this, it will recognize. See, how to actually fetch this logout title? This can be done by using a UiPath Explorer only. That's the reason we need actually UiPath Explorer. So we are discussing about UiPath Explorer, right? This is Explorer basically provides the properties of the object. That is the reason we need a UiPath Explorer. Okay. This is very, very critical component to identify the applications and objects under test. Okay, under test. The last one, the last component. What is the last component actually? The last component is UiPath Assistant. UiPath Assistant is used to execute. Basically, this is very useful to execute created processes. That means you have already created a process. So what is process again? Process is nothing but a multiple sequences. Multiple sequence contains multiple activities. Activities contain nothing but a single action. Okay. So we have already created a process. I want to execute this process with a particular timestamp. That means every day I want to execute a process where it will simply close all the notepads and all the Excel files at around 9 a.m. Every morning, I just want to run this job. That means every morning before going to start your work, please close all the open Excel files at 8 a.m. Okay. Close all Excel applications. Okay. At 8 a.m. At 9 a.m. every day. Every day. How to do that? This can be done by using a UiPath Assistant. UiPath Assistant. I know you don't have any knowledge about UiPath, much knowledge about UiPath. I will show you how it looks like. Okay. And tomorrow we'll get into UiPath Studio. This is UiPath Assistant. Okay. This is UiPath Assistant. So let me launch this one, UiPath Assistant. So I will explain how to install and all later. Okay. But I'm just connecting to the UiPath cloud. First of all, you have to connect to the UiPath cloud. Then only it will understand, otherwise it can't understand. So just connect it to the UiPath client. UiPath. Okay. Studio. So this is UiPath Studio. Console is very simple, but we need to focus more on creating a process. That is very important. Okay, I will explain each and every step thoroughly, and then I will help you post training. I will help you in creating a resume also for on UiPath. Okay, and I will send you the interview details, interview questions, what type of question they would ask and all. But at the end of the day, you will be comfortable and you can handle. Okay. UiPath process automation independently without taking help from others. That is very, very important, right? After getting a job, you no need to be dependent on any other person. Okay. So this is a basic overview about UiPath. Okay. So if you have any questions, just let me know. Meanwhile, it is taking time to open the UiPath. Let it come. Okay, so this is a console. This is the main console, or you can also call it as a start page of the UiPath. Okay, but there is actually very slow. Actually, my system, ideally it should open UiPath Assistant also. Okay. Let me try once again. Taking time. So anyway, I will show you here. This is a start page. Start page means here we can create a process. Okay. So if you click create, this is a blank process will be created automatically. Okay. So it will be created. So tomorrow we'll see how to create a process and how to add the activity. And I will explain these each and every option in detail, and then we'll continue further. Okay. So let me know if you have any questions in today's session. Today it's the only brief overview about UiPath. Okay. So I explained what are the advantages with UiPath, how many tools are there, like Automation Anywhere, okay, WorkFusion, okay, UiPath, and so on. What are the advantages and disadvantages with these tools? And what are the various components of UiPath? UiPath Studio and UiPath Explorer, UiPath Orchestrator, and UiPath UiPath Assistant. Okay. So this is the console of UiPath Studio. Okay. So if you have any questions, you can feel free to ask this question. It is a 1.5 month course. Okay. Post session will be thorough with all the concepts of UiPath process and so on. Okay, if you don't have any question, we can wind up for today. We'll catch up tomorrow at the same time. Yeah, sure. Okay, I'm going to stop sharing the screen. So we'll catch up tomorrow at the same time. Anil and Sharda and Nagendra. I'll share this video also day to day. Yeah. Okay then, thank you. Thank you all for joining.
Thank you.